Something is slowly killing you. You do it every day. You're probably doing it right now. It's sitting. Data suggests that sitting for a long time causes more than 30 chronic diseases and conditions, such as premature aging, decrease in bone density, increased inflammation, disrupts hormone function, sleep apnea. But the biggest impact is obesity. Have you seen Disney's WALL-E movie? Spoiler alert coming if you haven't watched this movie. The main plot line is about a lonely robot who finds love. But that's not what I find fascinating about this movie. WALL-E takes place in the future. The Earth is overrun with garbage and humans are forced to live in a spaceship until Earth becomes inhabitable again. Inside the spaceship, human society has everything done for them by robots and technology. People sit all day in a chair, and the effects are obesity and deconditioning of their bodies. When they try to get up from their chairs, their legs cannot support them. They are like babies learning to walk again. So if you watch this movie about the adorable robot WALL-E, pay attention to the humans in this movie and how all too real the scenario feels. Our human bodies were not meant to sit for long periods of time. Our bodies were designed to move. So today, I want to give you ways to earn your sit time. Before the Industrial Revolution, people moved significantly more than we do today. 90% of the world's population lived in agricultural communities. People led very active lifestyles. Even further back, thousands of years ago, humans were chasing and gathering their food. Now you might be thinking, but Nicole, modern conveniences have actually saved lives. And anyway, I work out. Surely I'm offsetting the negative effects of sitting by my workouts at the gym. If you do exercise, that is great. However, don't be fooled that because you work out, you do not need to worry about how long you're sitting each day. One of the ways to offset sitting is by being neat. No, not the tidy and that kind of neat. NEAT is the acronym for non-exercise activity thermogenesis. This is expanding energy on activities that are part of our daily lives. It's folding laundry, it's walking the dog, taking the trash out, washing dishes, even fidgeting counts. I would like you to meet my client, Lisa. Lisa commutes to work, sits at her desk, and is concerned about how much time she spends sitting. To support her health and to earn her sit time, I recommended to Lisa to walk daily for 30 to 45 minutes, lift weights 3 times a week, and 2 times a week do about 30-minute intervals on her elliptical. Lisa takes leisurely walks during her lunch, and that could be just around the office. She opts to stand as much as possible. She takes the stairs instead of the elevator. Lisa has incorporated the chair stretches that I'm about to give you, and she finds she is more focused and more productive at work. When at home, Lisa adds neat activities by washing dishes, playing with her kids, doing yard work, and even dancing. At the end of each day, Lisa has earned her sit time, so she can relax and watch her favorite shows before falling blissfully asleep. Earn your sit time. More movement throughout the day supports your health and impacts deeper sleep. So I would like to inspire everyone to commit to moving your body more on a daily basis. Sitting too long can cause physical pain, like tight shoulders, neck pain, tightness in your hips, back pain, and discomfort. The biggest cause of these issues is that we tend to sit facing our screens and we have minimal body movement. If we do move, we tend to move the entire chair with us. And who's guilty of staying in their chair and sliding across the room to get something? I want to show you some chair exercises that can combat the aches and pains of sitting. I recommend you mix these stretches up with getting up and moving around. As with any type of stretching or exercise program, it's always wise to check with your physician if you have any underlying medical conditions. I'm going to take you through a series of stretches that you can do at your desk. Ideally, I want you to hold each stretch for about 30 seconds to a minute, or you can hold it longer. You can absolutely do these all in one shot, but you can also spread out each stretch every hour. I recommend that you set a timer each hour that you're working and make sure that you incorporate these stretches throughout your day. So I've brought on some volunteers to help demonstrate these stretches so you can follow along at home and do the stretches as we do them. So you're going to place your hands behind your head and you're going to bend back and bring your chest up to the ceiling. I'm going to turn sideways so you can see a little bit better. So you want to have a straight back when you sit up and then you're going to arch back. Good, and then come up and sit straight. Next one, we're gonna grab underneath your chair and you're gonna lean away from that hand. Bring your ear to your shoulder. Good, and then rotate your chin to your shoulder. And you should feel the stretch all in the neck. Good, and then come back up to center. And we're going to switch sides. So grab onto your chair and lean away from that arm. Head, ear to shoulder. And rotate the chin down. Good. And then come back to center. The next stretch we're going to do is a front hip stretch. So you're going to sit on the edge of your chair. And you're going to turn sideways, extend your one leg back. Again, you can keep your knee bent if you want, if it's a little intense, or if you want a little bit more, straighten that leg out. And then you're going to bend back. So you should feel that all through the front of your body, especially your hip. Remember to keep your neck supported in the back. So Mike, actually bring your chin down a little bit. There you go. Yep. Good, come up, sit in the center again, and then we're gonna switch legs. Remember to sit on the edge of your chair, slide the one leg back. Good, and then arch back. Remember to breathe the whole time, and if you wanna straighten that leg out, you can. Good, and then come back up to center. The next one is a deep hip stretch. So you're going to take one leg, put your ankle on top of your knee. Good. Stay facing front. I'm just going to show you from the side. Make sure you're sitting up nice and tall. Make sure your back is not rounded. So sit up nice and tall. And then from there, you're going to lean forward from the hip as best you can, not from your back. So you don't want to do this. Hold that. Good, and then sit up nice and tall, and you're gonna turn towards the leg that you have up. So you can hold on to your knee if you don't have arms on your chair. If you have arms on your chair, you can use that to kind of gently twist. Make sure that you're sitting up nice and tall still. Good, and come back to center. And then let's switch legs. Good, remember to sit up tall, lean forward from the waist. Remember to keep breathing. Good, and sit up and then twist to the side. Good, and then come center. And the last stretch is going to be a back stretch. You're gonna take one hand and reach it down across towards your ankle. So you guys hold that. Make sure when you're reaching across that you're not kind of like slumping over. You really want to kind of think about your shoulder to your hip and that you're twisting. Good, and then sit up and then over to the other side. I like having the arm of the chair because you can kind of brace yourself. But even if you don't, you could probably hold on to the bottom of the chair and brace yourself. All right, and come back up to center. How's everybody feeling? Good? So how are you feeling? So does all this mean that you should give up sitting? No, absolutely not. But you do have to take care of your body. It's your most prized possession. Treat it like that. Let's not have the Wall-E movie come true. Be active, incorporate neat activities, stretch throughout the day, and it will all add up. Earn your sit time and earn a better quality of life. Thank you.